We're going to find out in the rest of this course that there are actually two very important functions in linear algebra. The first is the Axby function. The second one is the dot product, which is sometimes called the inner product. Now, you've probably seen the dot product already in a physics class or in another math class, but we're going to review it, and then we're going to connect it in the next unit to how to compute the length.
If we're given vectors x and y of size n, then the dot product is defined as follows. Now, what do we have here? We multiply the first components together, and then we multiply the second components together and add those to the first components. And then we keep doing that until we get to the last components. We multiply those together and we add those in as well. So one way to sort of visualize this, you do this times that plus this times that plus this times that, etc. We can write this more concisely as I equals 0 to n minus 1 of chi I times psi I. Let's do an example. If we're given two vectors, x and y, this time of size 3, then their dot product is given by 2 times 1 plus minus 1 times minus 2 plus 4 times minus 1. For a total of, let's see, that's 2 plus 2 is 4 minus 4. Interesting. In this particular case, the result is 0. Later, we're going to see that that means that these two vectors are orthogonal to each other. Now, let's have a look at an algorithm for computing the dot product. So we're going to compute alpha becomes the dot product of vectors x and y. And we know that that's defined as such. Now, to motivate an algorithm, let's look at this slightly differently. Let's think of this as taking alpha and first assigning 0 to it. After that, we multiply the first two components together and we add that to 0. After that, we multiply the next two components together and we add that to what already is an alpha, and so forth. Eventually, you multiply the last two components together and you add that to what you're accumulating in alpha. This motivates the algorithm given here. You start by setting alpha equal to 0. And then for I equals 0 to n minus 1, you take what is already accumulated in alpha and you add to it the product of the components chi I and psi I. Now, often we will use a slightly different notation to denote the dot product. Okay, the dot product is given by this. We will often write this as x transpose y. Okay, this T here means transposition. Now, what does transposition mean? If we expose the components of x and y, then the transposition means that you take x, which is a column vector, and you make it into a row vector as such. So the column vector turns into a row vector. Transposition means taking the vector and putting it on its side. And then multiplying a row vector times a column vector means multiplying the first components together and adding that to the second components multiplied together, and so forth. And that gives you then the same result as before. So in summary, the dot product of two vectors is defined by multiplying the corresponding components together and adding the results of that. We can write that in shorthand with a summation sign. And in this course, almost always, we will denote the dot product by x transpose y.